Hey everybody, today we are going to learn about another really awesome artist. His name is Pablo Picasso. So last time we were talking about different kinds of lines and shapes and how to express the way you feel with those lines, shapes, and colors. Last week with our abstract project, we're going to switch to a different style of artwork. This time it's called Cubism. And when you see it, you probably might even laugh because it looks kind of silly. And this kind of artist puts like parts of your face in the wrong place. Like one eye will be looking at you while the other eye is looking to the side. And sometimes the noses won't be in the right spot or the mouths will be in the wrong spot. So it's a really fun artist. And we're going to start by reading this book. Well, this book will be read to us, and then we'll talk about this artist afterward. All right, here we go.
Painted a Snowman. Written and illustrated by Amy and Greg Newbold. If someone asked you to paint a snowman, you would probably start with three white circles stacked one upon another. Then you would add black dots for eyes, an orange triangle nose, and a black dotted smile. But if Pablo Picasso painted a snowman, it would look like this. Not all artists paint the same. Can you find J.M.W. Turner's snowman lost in the blizzard? Blam! Roy Lichtenstein's snow hero saves the day. Georgia O'Keeffe's snowman wouldn't bloom long in the desert. A patchwork quilt, soft and cozy, wraps up Gustav Klimt's snow family. How many snowmen hide in Claude Monet's haystacks? A dust-colored snowman watches Pablita Velarde's ornamental birds. Jackson Pollock painted his snowman. Splish, splash, splat. In Salvador Dali's winter fantasy, snowmen drip like melty cheese. Rickety Rack, a stick snowman drives Paul Klee's wire car. Marc Chagall's snowmen cavort in a bright circus ring. Dot upon dot upon dot, Here's a Snowman by George Seurat. P.A. Mondrian's snowman is square. Do you see a carrot anywhere in there? Circles surround circles as Sonia Delaunay's snowman spins. The rhythms of the street make Jacob Lawrence's snowman smile. Vincent van Gogh's snowman swirls and curls in the wavy hills. And Grant Wood's famous snowman Gothic will never melt away. What will your snowman look like? The end.
Okay, let's go back and look at Pablo Picasso's snowman. Look at how different it looks. Let's start by talking about some of the things that you see on his snowman. You can just literally look at this and think about something you see. Like, I see a wall behind the snowman. It looks like it's inside. What are some of the things that you see? Well, I see a carrot nose that's kind of pointing up. I see one eye that's below the nose. I see another eye that's above the nose. I see three pieces of charcoal for his mouth. I see two mittens for his hands. I see a scarf. I see a line that goes right down his face, dividing it into more shapes. I also see that he is wearing a hat. Okay, so yeah, it looks very different. Let's talk about that. How is his snowman different from everybody else's snowman? Well, I can tell you right now that his snowman's eyes aren't above the nose. Both of them aren't. His face is divided into two different kinds of shapes. That's different. He has lots of lines that go through all of his shapes, making more and more shapes. There's a rectangular shape right here. There's like a triangular shape right here. Here's another long rectangle for his hat. These stripes kind of make some curvy rectangles, right? So his is different because it is full of all different kinds of shapes. So I also like to always talk about this, and I like to ask this question because it gives us a kind of clue as to what the artist is trying to tell us with his artwork. If this was the cover of a book, what do you think this book would be about? Well, if I were to guess, I would say maybe it's about a melting snowman that has made it all the way to spring and it's starting to warm up. So let's take a look. This is just a fun story about the kind of artwork that Pablo Picasso makes, which is called cubism. Cubism, that word cube is a shape. What a coincidence. There's a whole lot of shapes in all of his artwork. So let's take a look, closer look at one of his actual artworks that he made, one of his cubism artworks. Okay, here is one of his actual artworks that he made, not just a pretend story. Let's start by talking about this artwork. What can you see in this picture? Well, I see a flower on a hat. I see hair, eyebrows, eyes. I see an ear. I see a nose. I see a mouth. I see hands. I see a room. I see colors like red and green and light blue or even white. I see the color black. I see a red floor and yellow walls. Let's see. So let's also talk about what are some things that are different in this picture of a person. I know you can see lots and lots of differences because this is very, very different because it's the cubism style, right? The cubism style of artwork. So we see things like the biggest difference is her face is made out of all these different kinds of shapes. Do you see all the shapes? I see like a triangle shape here, a triangle shape there. That's not usually what we see on people's faces. It's very different. The eyes look very different, almost like a couple of buttons. And actually, I see an eye going sideways and another eye going up and down. And there's another eye and another eye. So it almost looks like she has four eyes. I can see both of her nostrils, even though her face is to the side like mine right now. She would have to be looking up to see both nostrils, right? I see her face. So another thing that's different is the colors on her face. People's faces aren't that color. The color she has on her face are purple and green and orange and yellow. Okay. So those are some big differences. I see more shapes up here on the hat, all different kinds of shapes, geometric shapes, the shapes you see in math class, like triangles and squares and rectangles. Okay, and then my favorite question, because it always gives us kind of a little bit a clue about what the artist is trying to tell us in this picture. And let's see if you can figure it out. The title, let's see if you can figure out the title by guessing what this would be. If this was the cover of a story, what do you think this story would be about? What's happening in this picture? space with Dan a moment to look for the clues. I'm looking for some clues right now, and I see, I know that it looks like it's a girl, and she's got long hair. I think she's holding something in her hands. I see her hands holding something over her nose and mouth. It does not look like she's happy. Okay. She's not smiling, right? In fact, her eyebrows go up like this, right? It's the face, right? Kind of. So when somebody's kind of making a face like that, you know, I think they're upset. So I think maybe, you know, maybe she's holding a tissue and she's kind of wiping away tears or something like that. Maybe she's very sad. And in fact, if you kind of found the same clues, you would see, or you would know that the title is The Weeping Woman. So this is The Weeping Woman. In fact, I know, because I know about this artist Picasso, that this is actually a painting of one of his friends, that he, whenever he hung out with this friend, she was always sad. So that's how he wanted to paint her. Okay. So that's just a little bit about this very strange style of artwork, where people's faces and the parts of their faces are all in different places and they're covered in all these shapes. And that style is called cubism. And we're looking at one of the artworks by this artist. His name is Picasso, Pablo Picasso. You probably heard that before. So now that we learned a little bit about Pablo Picasso, the kind of artwork that he makes, cubism, let's get ready to make one of these artworks ourselves. So get out your paper and pencil and maybe some colors and take a moment to get ready, because we are going to start making this kind of artwork in just a moment. I'll give you a few moments to gather those supplies now. Go ahead. Okay, so let's get started here. And if you haven't figured out by now, we are going to be making an artwork just like Picasso, except for we are going to be making a face that is cute. Well, we are like Picasso, going to be making a face in the cubism style, cubism. The first thing we are going to do is we're going to start by drawing some of the facial features first. We're not going to draw like a circle or anything like that. So if you remember, the cubism style is all about shapes. So if you want to start by drawing your nose, and I want you to pick a geometric shape for your nose, okay? So some examples of geometric shapes can be what? Circle and square and triangle. Okay, there's a couple of different kinds of triangles. All right, we got half circles and hexagons and all sorts of stuff, pentagons. Okay. Let's start by drawing our nose. So I'm going to put the nose right in the middle of the paper, and I'm going to switch to marker here. Okay, so I'm going to start by drawing a triangle. So if you would like to go ahead and draw a shape for your nose, go ahead and do that now. You know, maybe you can pick one of the ones that I've drawn, or you can think of your own geometric shape. Let's see, there's diamond shapes, right? Let's see, there's long skinny rectangles, octagons. Okay, so hopefully by now you have created, you've drawn at least the shape for a nose. Okay, let's continue. Here, let's draw one of the eyes, just one. Now remember, in Pablo Picasso, we are drawing a face from all different angles at the same time. So even though we're drawing a face, we're going to draw parts of the face that are sometimes looking at you and sometimes looking to the side and sometimes looking up or down or to the other side, all at the same time in the same place. So right now my nose is going that way, but I think I'm going to draw an eye that's looking at us, straight at us. And I'm going to use another geometric shape. And this time I am going to draw a half circle. And for the pupil, the little part, I'm going to go ahead and draw a triangle inside there. Okay, so there is the beginning of my eye. Go ahead and choose a shape or two to draw your eye. You can do that right now. You can choose one of the shapes that I've drawn, or maybe you can make your own. Geometric shapes is what we're using. Okay, so hopefully by now you've drawn your eye. If not, you can always pause this video whenever you need to. Let's see, I'm gonna draw the ear. And for the ear, I'm just going to draw a circle. And then for the parts of the ear, I'm gonna draw another circle. And then another circle. Okay, so I've drawn three circles. So go ahead and choose a geometric shape to draw for your ear. You can use more than one shape if you would like. Okay, so right now you should be drawing your geometric shape for your ear. And for the face of my cubism drawing, I'm actually going to draw a line right down the middle because I want to divide the face into two different shapes. And I think I am going to choose another shape for the other eye. So this time I'm going to use two half circles put together. Kind of like a frowny line, football shape, and a smile line put together. And then I'm going to continue the side of my face, connect it to the ear, and then underneath the nose, I am going to start drawing the bottom of the face, and I think I'm going to put another shape for the bottom of the face. Okay, so why don't you take a moment to draw the other eye and maybe start drawing half of the face. Now, if you want to draw the same thing as me, you can do that too. Or you can make up your own shapes. It's up to you. Whatever you feel like. Okay, so right now you should be drawing your second eye. And maybe half of the shape of the face. We'll draw the other side in a moment. Just want to give everybody a chance to draw their other eye in that part of the face. I'm actually going to add a circle to my nose to give that a nostril shape. You can do the same thing for yours if you would like. You don't have to. So, yep, my nose is going that way, but the nostril is going that way. Now you can change yours if you would like. You don't have to. Okay, I'm going to start drawing shapes for my mouth. All right, so I'm actually going to use the letter M.
And this letter M is going to stop on the line. And then at the bottom of the M, I'm going to make it go up just a little bit on both sides to make it look like my person is smiling. You can do the same thing if you would like. And then I'm going to connect both sides with a straight line. And then put a smile line underneath that for my lips. So if you would like to go ahead and take a moment to draw a mouth on yours, you can use the same one as mine if you would like. You do not have to. But take a moment right now to go ahead and add the mouth or the lips. Okay, so hopefully by now you've drawn the mouth. I am going to start drawing some of the hair. Okay, so underneath the ear, I think I'm going to draw like a wavy line, like a water line. Maybe lower my screen here so you can see. Okay, so if you want to do the same kind of hair as me, that's fine. You don't have to. I'm going to draw like a straight line here. And add a repeating shape. It's a little letter C. Give it some eyelashes. Now, if you remember when a shape or a line or a color repeats, it is called a pattern. You should know that from our previous lessons. I'm going to add a shape for the inside of the other eye. If you didn't do that yet, you can go ahead and do that now. I'm just going to repeat this line over again for the eyelashes on the other side. I'm going to continue my hair. So if you've started drawing your hair, you can do the same thing. Okay, so right now you could be drawing some lines for hair, maybe finishing up the other eye, maybe adding some eyelashes, or adding more detailed lines for your hair. Oops. There it goes. Okay, I'm going to continue with some wavy lines. Okay, so right now you could be adding some details for your hair if you would like, or you can possibly be doing the same thing as me. It's up to you. So I'm repeating this line shape over and over again. So that's another example of a pattern, a line pattern, to go with our style, our cubism style of making pictures of people's faces from all different directions all at the same time. So take a moment to finish up your hair. Go ahead and do that now. Well, part of your hair, right? Okay, while you do that, I think I'm going to add a shape for an eyebrow. I'm just going to use a triangle. And while you guys are doing that, I'm going to color in some shapes with my black marker that I'm using right now. Okay, so now you should be finishing up the hair. I'm gonna draw a couple more pieces of hair coming off in this direction. Okay, so hopefully by now you've had a chance to start or finish your hair. Remember, if you ever fall behind, you can go ahead and pause that video. And I am actually going to start adding some color. So I'm going to switch the crayons. I drew with a marker to create some contrast. Okay, so you can see I have added some color to my cubism portrait. Now, if you're doing the same drawing as me right now, that's okay. You can do the same colors or maybe change the colors. Or if you're doing a completely different portrait, that's okay too. And remember, this is a cubism abstract type of artwork. So the colors do not have to be realistic. Okay, for example, my portrait of a person has a blue nose and kind of rainbow spaghetti looking hair. And there's even a green square on her cheek and some orange under the eyes. And there are some wavy blue and gold pieces of hair. And sometimes the hair is coming this way and sometimes the hair is also going that way at the same time. And the face, one of the eyes is looking at you and one of the eyes is looking to the side and the face is kind of looking to the side and the mouth is looking at you. So just like Picasso, we are creating a cubism portrait and we're putting different facial features from all different directions right now. And you can finish by adding some different colors to your portrait. You can go ahead and do that now. Okay, so while you were coloring, I just wanted to say, I hope you had fun learning about the cubism artist Pablo Picasso and the kind of very strange portraits with the facial features going in all different directions and strange colors. I hope you had fun because it is kind of a silly project. If you didn't get a chance to finish it up, don't worry. You can finish it up whenever you have time and then bring it to class to show me next time. I love seeing your artwork. Please feel free to share your artwork with me during our live Zoom meetings. That would be amazing. Here's a little challenge for you over the next week if you're feeling up to it. If you would like to try and do this project again, maybe draw a person from your house and sometimes draw them when they're looking at you and sometimes draw while they're looking to the side, but all in the same picture, not two different pictures, one picture of one person's face while they're looking at you or to the side and to the side both. Like I said, I hope you had fun. I know I did, and I can't wait to see your finished artwork next time in class. Go ahead and just bring it to class to show me next time. I hope you have fun. Have a great day.